Got some big breaking news coming in this hour. North Korea has said that it is taking steps to dismantle its nuclear test site. The state news agency, KCNA, has said that it will invite the foreign media to observe the ceremony. So that's a big story we're tracking here on WION at 7:20 p.m. IST. There's been a development as far as this dismantling of the nuclear facility goes. We're hearing that North Korea has announced that it is going to carry out a ceremony to mark the dismantling of the nuclear site. It's taking steps to that in that direction, and that a ceremony will be carried out to this effect. Now, remember, these are being considered measures by North Korea to perhaps indicate its commitment to denuclearization and, of course, keeping its own country's best interests in mind. This gesture might be considered symbolic for many, but it is an important gesture all the same, given that it comes ahead of the all-important June 12th meeting between Kim Jong-un and Donald Trump. In addition to announcing this ceremony, there's another point to note here. The North Koreans have also said that the foreign media will be invited to observe the ceremony of the dismantling of the nuclear site. Of course, the big question at this point is what exactly is the intent here? What is the message that's being sent out? Is it directed solely towards the United States and the President Donald Trump? What is the end game for North Korea and Kim Jong-un? Remember, the Kims have maintained secrecy as far as a number of things within the country goes. In fact, they've also guarded their nuclear facilities with a sense, almost a ferocious sense of authority so far. So for this to be happening, the fact that this dismantling is going to happen and it's going to be broadcast through the foreign media is an interesting point. Ramesh Ramachandran, WION senior correspondent, on the broadcast with me for more. Ramesh, make sense of this for us. Just a confidence building measure ahead of the June 12th meeting, or something more than that?
Well, it is high on symbolism, no doubt. I assure the fact that they've decided to shut down the Punggye-ri nuclear testing site on the 23rd of this month is indicative of the indication that North Korea is serious about these talks with the U.S. scheduled for the 12th of June in Singapore. But that said, this is the only test site which was used for all six tests by North Korea in the last several years. So this is high on not only on symbolism, but also substantive issue that North Korea is indicating to the world that it is serious about non-proliferation and on denuclearization.
Right. And Ramesh, also, the United States president has maintained so far, and of course his administration, that there isn't going to be any let up on the sanctions on North Korea till the time the talks happen and there is some sort of, you know, something of significance that comes out of that. The fact that Pyongyang is making these attempts at rapprochement, if you will, in terms of letting those three American citizens go, this symbolic ceremony of Punggye-ri nuclear site, how do we, are we seeing like a misbalance perhaps of the power equation here? Is the North trying to concede in some ways to the United States demands in a big way?
Well, in a sense, nuclear issues will be front and center of the U.S.-North Korea talks, Aisha. Now, the problem arises in semantics. North Korea says its weapons are for its own defense, a deterrence against any U.S. adventurism on the Korean Peninsula. At the same time, North Korea says weapons are a means of insurance, so to speak, against the U.S. designs. But on the other hand, U.S. says North Korea must not keep any weapons going forward, and it one express commitment going forward that North Korea will abide by those commitments. So that's where things stand at the moment. It remains to be seen whether they can bridge this difference going forward in the next few weeks before the U.S.-North Korea talks in Singapore.
Right. And you were, of course, there for that summit between Kim Jong-un and Moon Jae-in. The sentiment at that point, Ramesh, was quite strong in the statements made by both leaders. They said that they want to pursue harmony between the two Koreas. And there was also mention of, you know, keeping things on the peninsula within these two parties. Do you think that is an interesting point and perhaps one that needs to be taken note of, that this gesture might well be also directed towards South Korea as much as it is to the United States.
Absolutely, Ayesha. North Korea says the onus will be equally on South Korea and the U.S. By that, they mean that U.S. must reconsider stationing troops, American troops on the Korean Peninsula. They must possibly revisit the South Korea-U.S. treaty alliance, which has stood the test of time. But that said, in a sense, North Korea has lobbed the ball in America's court, in Trump's court, and it expects Trump to announce some sort of conciliatory gesture between now and the talks when they happen on the 12th of June next month. Also on the issue is the fact that this is a more or less a dispute between China, North Korea and the U.S. So China will remain a key player in the negotiations going forward as well.
All right. Ramesh, as you've pointed out for us before, so we can't forget that this doesn't involve just two countries. There are many other players involved as well. We leave it at that. Thank you for bringing us that perspective on a developing story, one of import ahead of that June 12th summit between Donald Trump and Kim Jong-un. Kim Jong-un has said that there's going to be a ceremony to mark the shutting down of North Korea's nuclear site. With that, we're wrapping up this edition of the newscast. Thanks for joining us here on WION. Much more on the other side. Stay tuned.